Patients or families with liver disease may have heard about the term MELD score. MELD score was designed many years ago to predict the 90-day mortality after a procedure called TIPS procedure, which is a shunt inside the liver. Later, they found out that it's a very good predictor for patients with cirrhosis and their survival or mortality. And in 2002, they have employed this for patients being evaluated for transplant and to decide who gets priority for transplant. MELD score uses four different blood work numbers. The four different numbers that are used are one, bilirubin, which is how jaundiced the patient is. The second number they use is INR, which is how well the blood is clotting, because liver makes clotting factors. And if the liver's sick, it can't make clotting factors, so their blood is very thin. The third number it uses, it's called creatinine, which is how well the kidney is working. When the liver gets very sick, the kidneys can get hurt too, and their creatinine can go up. The last number, which is the one that was added recently to the MELD score calculator, is called sodium, which is an electrolyte in your blood. As the liver disease advances, patients will have low sodium in their blood. Based on these four numbers, when you put these numbers and get a MELD score, it can range anywhere from 5 to 40 or higher. For listing purposes, anything above 40 is still listed as 40. If the MELD score is less than 10, the risk of dying in the next 90 days is less than 3%, which is less than 3 out of 100 people will die related to complications from liver disease. Whereas if their MELD score is over 40, their risk of dying in the next 3 months or 90 days is over 80%. So more than 80 out of 100 people will die in the next 90 days, which also emphasizes why a person with the higher MELD score should get transplanted, because that person may not be alive for the next organ to become available. Not always is the MELD score predictive of how sick the patient is. So UNOS, the organization that allocates liver transplants, they have recognized certain conditions to be at high risk for death, though the patients may have lower MELD score. To name a few examples, the first one is hepatocellular carcinoma or liver cancer. People with liver cancer are at increased risk of dying because the cancer can spread to other organs, and that's why it's considered as a priority for transplant and they get MELD exception points. The other condition is called hepatopulmonary syndrome. It is a disease where the liver affects the lung, so they can have low oxygen level in the blood. So these people are also at increased risk of the disease progressing from the hepatopulmonary syndrome to where they don't get enough oxygen to the organs and have risk of dying. So they get extra points for transplant or MELD exception points. The third condition that is commonly used is also called portopulmonary hypertension. So because of liver disease, they have high pressure in the lung blood vessels that can make them go into right heart failure. So the heart has to pump at higher pressures. And with time, the right heart gets weaker and it can fail. So because of that specific reason, these patients get extra points for transplant only after their pressure is controlled with medications. There are a few other reasons for people to get MELD exceptions. One is ascites or fluid buildup in the abdomen, if that is uncontrolled with water pills, and if they cannot get a stent procedure in the liver called the TIPS procedure. The same thing with fluid buildup in the lungs, and if it's not controlled with a stent procedure or they cannot get a stent procedure for any reason, they can also qualify for MELD exception. For any patient to be listed for transplant, they have to be evaluated by the liver transplant center. The physician will first see you and talk to you, find out your whole history, and based on that, decide if you may benefit from a transplant. Once all the testing is done, then your case will be discussed in a patient selection conference, which is a meeting where all the physicians, the social workers, psychologists, all the team members that have seen you will be there. We'll go through all the testing you have had, and if everything looks good, then we decide that you're good to be placed on the transplant list. Then we submit your case to UNOS to put you on the transplant list.